Welcome back, heroes, to another episode of Might and Magic 7 with me, Magix. And after we have finished the game once on the Dark Path, I will now attempt to replay the game with the Rev 4 mod, which I will play the first time ever, and we'll do the Light Path. So stay tuned and let's go!
You heard what she said.
Okay, guys, you know the drill. We will now recreate our party.
Don't leave home with
take me.
I want
in. Well, we have to choose the right voices again.
I want
please choose me.
Yeah, let's go with this. This time we will play the Light Path, but I don't think anything will really change here. So let's go with the elemental schools again. Recreate our party leader Conan. He has reborn in a new age, kind of. History repeats itself, and this time he will be a Knight of the Light, so that's that. Harmony, where are you?
Choose me. Pick me.
There you are.
Pick me for your party.
Pick me.
Oh, come on.
Please choose me.
Pick me.
Please pick me.
Choose me.
Don't get me killed.
What could go wrong?
Pick me for your party.
Pick me.
I won't
choose me.
Pick me.
Pick take me.
Pick me for your
pick me.
Do they sound alike? No, right? That's fine. Sorcerer, it was Genova, I think. Okay. And then the question is, you definitely get spirit. We don't care about mind. I guess I will start with merchant again. What will be
don't get me killed.
Please.
Our off class? Because I still want to run knight, cleric, sorcerer. The thief can get to Grandmaster disarm trap, but it isn't necessary, to be honest. Could do with Master, but I don't even know if Master is necessary, because after the Haunted Mansion, chest felt kind of easy. That might be the case because we had rings with disarm plus 25, right? Stuff like that. But you could get that in this run too. And you can tank the damage a little bit and heal and rest and stuff like this, so it's not like your life depends on the disarm skill, though I think that expert is at least necessary. And knights can't get it to expert, unfortunately. That is a problem. But the paladin can't either. And to be honest, the paladin doesn't bring anything to the table that the knight couldn't do. Besides that he can cast some self magic, but that's not good enough in my opinion. Yeah, the archer is kind of the same. You don't need the bow to Grandmaster, really. They can get disarming to expert, if I remember correctly. What else can we do? I'm not a fan of the druid. I mean, since we are running light side instead of the dark side, you don't have to get the dragon's egg, I think. Though I can't remember what the second promotion on the light path is, so it could be wrong if they still want the dragon's egg. But that is ridiculous, just to make alchemy to grandmaster rank. And I'm not that much into alchemy. The sorcerer can still get it to master if we want to. And you can buy the black potions in the higher ranked shops. It's boring to rerun the monk again, even though I liked him. Ranger is kind of crappy, but maybe that makes the run harder. So if we go with the thief, it would mainly be for another character that can grandmaster the leather armor and dual wield the dagger. So he can deal quite nice damage. The ranger is mostly there for axes, so that you have an Grandmaster axe user. But any other skill besides identify monster, I think, he can only get to expert level. He can get everything to expert level, but expert level is not what you really want or need. So it's kind of pointless, in my opinion. Therefore, if the monk is out of the equation, we either run a thief, right? Then we don't have to worry about disarming, because he goes with disarm master at the base class. So if you get to master 7, I think you have no issues at all with any traps in the game. Grandmaster dagger can add a lot of damage. That's for sure. And you have at master the chance to cause triple damage equal to the skill. So if you pump up the dagger a lot, you have two daggers, you attack very quickly, you have a nice chance to get a lot of damage in. With this, and we can steal items from shops and save money this way. We are not that much reliant on the shops, and with the merchant skill, it's kind of pointless. I'm also not a fan of running like two sorcerer, two clerics or something like that. I mean, with the light side, you don't need two characters to get to Grandmaster, really. You use a light magic mostly for the buffing stuff, so you only need one character that gets really good with light magic, whereas the other character can focus on his offensive spells more. So in this run we want high fire air magic, because implosion and incinerate are probably the best single target spells this time around. So maybe we want to ease up a little bit of the skill point burden to run a class double, but that's kind of wasted. Well, the paladin can get Grandmaster shield, but that only really adds the shield spell to his protection, and you get that already with the expert air magic, so there is really no use in air mastering the shields. Arms master, it's really only good at Grandmaster, I think. I mean, it's still fine, but without mastering this, it's kind of weak for him. He can get the sword to master, so he can dual wield. And then he can dual wield with the mace, which he can Grandmaster, and paralyze. Has a chance to paralyze, that's also not that important. He can dual wield mace and sword, I think, though I'm not sure if it works like spear and sword. You can wield a sword in the left hand. The ability to use a spear in one hand, so with the one-handed mace, I think you can dual wield, but I've never done that, so I'm not entirely sure. And the ranger really is only there for ex-grandmaster. They do a lot of damage, that is true. But he can't get really fast with this. And his disarm kind of sucks, so if we go with ranger, we have use for axes. If we go with a four paladin, we have use for maces. But we can also give the maces to our cleric, I think. So yeah, paladin is out of the equation. With an archer, you can master spear and kind of dual wield spears, which is not bad. But I don't really like archers for casting stuff. Arms Master can also be only expert. Bow is not really necessary to pump up that much. Then he only has really spear. Can use chain and leather, I think. Yeah, let's try it out with the thief. Let's see how much damage we can squeeze out of a thief. So we need a mean looking thief.
Don't leave, please.
How about me? I can do it.
Choose me.
Pick me.
Choose me.
How about me? I can do it.
Yeah, Rodney looks like the evil thief. He doesn't need intellect or personality, so I think that's fine. And let's give him a cool name like Jeff. No one suspects Jeff to be an evil thief, so here we go. You get the disarm trap. I don't think identify item to master is maybe good enough, so that we don't have to get our sorcerer to pick it up. She could get it to Grandmaster, but I don't think that's necessary at all. Oh, not identify monster, identify item. You don't need 100% success, because with one ring that adds like 25 to the skill. You could see it in the last run, we had so many of them. That's totally fine to have it at Master. So we could go with identify item too. Then he has dagger stealing and this stuff. How high can your alchemy go? Not that high. Leather can be Grandmaster for a lot of resistances. He's kind of squishy with leather, that's sure. He can also dual wield sword and dagger. That can also be nice, but I think double dagger is a little bit better. Because the triple damage on both daggers. Yeah, I think that's better, and can also master the merchant skill. So we could give him all the inventory stuff, like merchant, identify, disarm trap, so he can be like our miscellaneous mule. And then I can focus more on the magic stuff on our cleric. Take away the merchant on 100%. Don't think you need it. We had no money issues in the late game, and triple should be good enough. I don't think it's yeah, let's do this actually. This way we can focus more on the spellcasting, really on the spellcasters, and keep the other skills to our melee characters, because they have more freedom with their skill points, usually. Yeah, then let's add Mind Magic 2 here. Go back to Water Magic here. So, Jeff, you will grab all the shopping stuff. That's good. And for our knights, Sword Leather, let's give him the spear skill so he has more options with the weapons in the early game. And well, Arms Master doesn't really matter in the beginning. Shield is also kind of pointless. Well, let's go with the bow, so we have at least one that can use the bow. Yeah, there's our party. Again, Conan, the knightly barbarian leader.
I'm your man.
Tally ho! You want to ride high?
He needs
ride with me.
Yeah, this is a cool voice.
You need a strong warrior like myself.
Pick me!
You need a strong warrior like myself.
Exactly, that is the voice we want. And yeah, it's our male human knight. Jeff the thief. Stupid goblin in the party, that's maybe also for fun there. Harmony the cleric, and Genova the sorceress. And do this again, reduce all the luck. We don't need luck, we have the skills. Then for our sorceress, no might. No personality. For our cleric, no might needed. No intellect needed. She has just to be the dumb healer. For our goblin, might is still kind of important to a thief. Speed is also fine. So I only think we dump him down a little bit more. I wonder how you can disarm traps with such low intellect, but he's a master. He has maybe the luck of the gods, even though his luck is crappy. Who knows? Who knows? You don't need personality and intellect either. And let's buff up your power here. I want your might up so that you deal a lot of damage, and goblins, yeah, have a pretty high advantage in might, so you can already get to the next threshold. You are the personality, and you need the intellect. You can also buff it to 30. Well, okay, that's the limit for humans. They are more the well-rounded classes, and then I again think only buff up the accuracy to the next threshold, I think of 15. And then we have still 14 points left. Man, so many. I wonder where I dumped this last time. Well, increasing your endurance hurts, but let's just round it up a little bit here. Goblins have also an advantage in speed. It's really nice. At least in the skill point distribution, so yeah, let's make use of that. Doesn't matter in the end, because on the light path you have Day of the Gods, and at Grandmaster rank your attributes will explode into ridiculous numbers, so it's only really about the early game, so who cares. And we have 1 point left, so give you one might, just because I'm gracious, and yeah, that will be the party for this run. Now let's go. You know the drill. And welcome to the Rev4 mods from Big Daddy Jim. And he would like to welcome us, that's nice. And he hopes that our enjoy of experience in the game will be great. And yeah, that's about it. So, mod has been installed. We get some horseshoes here. Found a healer. Let's check for some nice NPCs. Quartermaster, no. Maybe someone that buffs up disarming a little bit in the beginning. Well, you can also see that the items are kind of reworked. That's nice. We have a broadsword and an ogre fighting stick, so this deals up to 12 damage. This is only 1 to 9, I think. So let's go with the sword. Can sell this. Don't need this. And for our dumb knight here, some reagents. And the common dagger, looks nice. And yeah, here are the cellar, so you can keep that. Cool looking mace, basic spells, no enchantment on the ring. Well, speed plus one. Who wants more speeds? Well, let's give it to Harmony so she can heal a little bit faster.
New spell. A perfect mix.
And the journey staff, sure. So we are equipped. Skills are set. Let's explore. We have 200 gold in our bank. Lisa the Bard. This was the girl that gives you the instrument. We are going to win. Just declaring it now. Yeah, she owns the instruments. Okay. So yeah, still 500 gold, okay. She has also a lot of HP, so that she can't accidentally die, I guess. What was this? It added some hit points or something? And fire resistance temporarily. Oh, okay. That was a nice buff. Let's check out the shops. Anything new here? Can have the spear. Well, looks cool, right? Really nice overwork, even a pitchfork.
Thanks. Come again.
Well,
see anything you want?
They also have already studded leather, so seems like they also have reworked the shops. Maybe we can use them a little bit more. We have the stealing skill, so can also make use of stealing this time. That can be fun. Let's gain the memberships. Body expert already here. Wow. Okay. So, seems like the trainers are relocated. Yeah, all the memberships. Master sword fighter, okay. So, seems like this time I have to use my notes to get all the trainers in my... Yeah, to find all the trainers later on. Chimney sweep, Gypsy, Watermaster, peasant, okay. Let's restore some hit points here. Good, okay, got this. Is Mr. Melwick still here? Nope. Tim the Piper is here, so no fireball stuff for us this time. Makes the dragon possibly not doable. Unless we have four bows and can still do this. Show the Tinker, okay. What is this? This was the Haze Pedestal. Yeah, exactly. And there is Count Zero. Who are you? And this time there are no dragonflies. Interesting. But goblins in the distance. This was the Luckwell, right? So, some more luck for you, my friend. You are now a lucky bandit. Let's give it to our mage so she doesn't blow up when we accidentally can't disarm. There is no disarmor here, so... Yeah, we need a lot of skill points on our thief this time around, because he will get a lot of these misc skills. But I still want him to put out some damage at least. We found 1000 gold, nice. Good thing I checked this well. So, free gold for everyone. Sure. What the heck? What the sure. Heck? That looks pretty strong. His Grace, okay. The Western Lowlands. Okay, about the missing quant, yeah. You know all the quests, but there's also the priest quest here. It's relocated to this island, so I suspect that you can come back here, right? And the Fire Mage Grandmaster is also here. And a new quest, the Sacred Relic of the Order of Fire, the Scroll of Mage Wonkar, has been lost for many years. The caravan that was transporting this relic from Armondale to Rakada never made it out of the Barrow Downs. Okay. Find the Lost Scroll of Wonkar and return it to me, and I will grant all elemental magic users in your party expert fire magic with a skill of 8. Okay. Don't know how this works, but I like the Barrow Downs, so we will find out. It was a nice dungeon, I like the maziness. It was not too mazy, so you could make your way around there, and with the 1000 gold, I think it's time for the bow skill. One more character, at least. Let's see if we can buy a bow here. Yeah, there is one crossbow, and then I actually want to identify this. Wow, Duelist Blade of Acid. Already 24 damage plus 12 points of body damage. That's ridiculous. Well, Conan, I guess you can carry us again through the early game. Found the carry again. Yeah, well, let's take it. Save, actually. New ref 4. Maybe it's necessary because the opponents will also be stronger, so. Eager to see that. Wizard's Eye is shortly running out, so yeah, I hope the game will be more difficult for me this time. So this was the Dragon's Cave where the missing contests were, and there are dragonflies on the top this time.
I'm not sure.
Wow, come on. What items did you drop here? The Coding Wizard. Lives on the main island, BDJ, Big Daddy Jim. All those who have gained Grandmaster status in their chosen profession should seek out this wizard. It is reported that he offers to cross-train them into a second profession. So we can make dual characters. Then we can not only make a thief, but maybe also something else. Okay, maybe train our sorcerer to alchemy grandmaster with a dual cross skill. So oh, maybe. Is the cave behind your house the abandoned temple? No, it's the dragon's cave. Morkarak the Pitiless. Okay. The cave has been magically sealed for ages by the Watchers. The abandoned temple is buried in the hill south of my house. You can get to it by entering the caves at the top of the hill. So this time we can't even go into this dragon's cave anymore. So the dragon is sealed.
How are you?
Here you can get seashells for 100 gold, but let's wait on this. Well, there we find some more gold, some fire resistance, and let's try to beat those stupid dragonflies. Hope that our swordsman friends won't die. Well, they are already firing. We have fire protection, so come on guys, beat the first enemies here. Or fail on hitting. Oh, but Conan already wrecks face again. So here you go. Be blessed. Oh, nice. First enemies in the game. I want that Day of the Gods. Nice hit for two. Wow, and even the bow is strong. We have another bow, so that will be fun. Those guys will take care of this dragonfly, but they will probably die. Here's already a queen. Okay, so I see that we get better items, but the opponents are also stronger here. Because we never face a queen in the normal game. Day of the Gods, so now we should be able to hit anything. The cannon also still works for the ship. Well then, let's face more enemies, or get the bow skill up. I think that's better. Found some foods. We have one more bow. So we give this bow to our goblin here.
I don't have the skill.
Yeah, okay. Then grab the skill at least for everyone. We have the money now. Double speed still works.
Need a new weapon?
I want to identify, please. Devil Bone Bow. Wow. Wow. Okay, learn the skills, guys. So, if you find the fourth bow, we can shoot our way.
Need a new weapon?
Through this. Here you go. Here you go. Also, good might now, good power. Let's fight us some goblins. Trying to find the last bow we are missing. It's one of the contestant items, so well, there are a huge amount of enemies here. Reminds me of Might and Magic 6 now. And I wish I would have the fireball here. Remember that the goblins are still shooting, so that was crazy. So even with the Day of the Gods, this is not easy.
That was too easy.
Here comes Count Zero. Help us, man, help us. let's heal up. Or even hobgoblins here. Need Goblin Slayer. Come on.
It's just a small
Wow, that's a lot of goblins, but that's how it's supposed to be. Goblins never hunt alone. Good. Hopefully not count killing Count Zero here. Because he's so close.
Easy.
Yeah, we make quick work of them. We are like glass cannons. With Day of the Gods, we are quite strong, to be honest. We get a lot of money for this. But and we could also use the Haste Pedestal, maybe. But that's risky because we don't have good cure weakness yet.
Do you need healing?
Here for 10 bucks, it's fine.
Go in peace.
Just 4 goblin kills. We have found this extra money. There was also a chest here, yeah, now that I remember. It's kind of days ago since we were the last time here, so... Well, there's the last bow, I suppose. And a region tournament shield. Man, what do you find here? Ridiculous. Well then, guys, you are set now. I have to get the shield skill next, I guess. Let's kill the goblins first. Let's rebuff this. Day of the Gods lasts really a day, so only care for the fire resistance. Well then, now we can kill stuff. We have four bows. There are now a lot of goblins and dragonflies.
Killed it.
Yeah, killed it. I am not willing to go into turn-based here. That are too much enemies for my taste. And if we can't dodge some of the shots, we will definitely die, I think. Because right now we are mostly like glass cannons. We deal a lot of damage with these ridiculous items. But besides this great shield, our defense is kind of poopy. So, come on, nice. Have to be careful, our healing is also not that great right now. Finish that one slowly but steadily, working our way in the swamp. The dragonflies are to our right. Damn it, stop evading, man.
Bring on a bigger challenge.
There's a regen for the red potion. And now they're coming, all of these goblins again. Some good shots in here. Oh, they hit us too. To be careful.
It's just a small wound.
Oh, even with Day of the Gods and all our equipment, it's definitely still challenging. Come on, guys.
It's just a small wound.
Oh, even a goblin lord here. Found the leader, eh? Well, normally you kill them in Harmondale because you need level 4 or something. And even then, you kind of have to regenerate a lot, but yeah. Here we go. Thank God for our bow skill. There are some more. One is running away. This one. Kill it maybe with fire. He can even evade this. Let's try to beat those last goblins here. There is another dragonfly queen.
I need healing.
Yeah, you need healing. Sure, here you go. Take the HP, and some goblins are in this hut. And then let's kill the deserters here. We'll let their comrades alone. And yeah, we have cleared the swamp now. Good. Seems like the goblins and knights have fought against these dragonflies. Well then, let's get our money and then maybe buy some more skills. Good, good. At least they only drop gold and not more ridiculous items. But let's check this chest here. Let's hope that we don't die. No, okay. Stone axe is not useful. Find some good basic items here. Yeah, even a good chain. Wow. So we already found the floor tile with Moon and Signar. Yeah, sure. It's a quest item. Spell points plus 13. That's good for our healer. And armor class plus 17. Yeah. That's going to you. Because you are the squishiest. And she will be buffed with steel chainmail. Guess the hammer is already a little bit better. And this shield. So let's give the armor class to our squishiest character. And we found the seashell. Don't need this. Potion bottle. Yeah. cure poison, sure. And the leather armor, I think.
I can't use that.
But we can use it later. We can make a red potion already, right? So got that out of the way. We found the floor tile, so also found the seashell. We can buy the instrument, I guess. But let's explore maybe a little bit more. Ah, you gained 5 hit points from the starting well. Okay. Okay, okay, I see. And yeah, there's a treasure chest hidden here. Good bow. Let's hopefully not die. Found a recurve bow, okay. Yeah, let's explore a little bit more around the coast. Maybe we find another chest or something.
Beats me.
Well, you find a royal leather armor here. Come on. It's a little bit over the top. Thought this makes the game harder, but you get the good equipment. Maybe you need it also, so do I know. First time playing this. Let's go to the shops here. We found the Warrior Mage promotion. But we are too inexperienced and bow expert. Well, kind of like a backdoor here. Yeah, I mean, what skills can we learn? Axe and staff? No need for that right now. So we are set on the weapons department for now. Yeah, good bow.
Thanks.
Maybe it's a contestant bow, so let's keep it there for now. Armor.
See anything you want?
You get leather. You get shields. You get leather. And identify this, please. Well, a royal leather of might. So as much as I would love to give this to our sorceress, this is for our knight. Thief, whatever. Because now he is way mightier. Already dealing a lot of damage with this puny dagger here. It will be better. She can't wear these yet, but in the next city maybe. Now we have two of these recurve bows. Don't know why. Well, then let's upgrade it a little bit.
See anything you want?
Nope, but you can have this.
Thanks a lot. Need a new weapon?
And you can have this. Okay.
Thanks. Come again.
What was in here? Body expert. Okay, they want me to get to this first, I guess. Master sword. Get the memberships here. You can quickly visit the shop here.
Oh, how are you?
Learn skills. Sure, you can get the alchemy skill again. I don't think there's anything else I want here yet. Identify monster. Yeah, let's just get it. Doesn't matter. So we have the skills at least.
Can I help you with anything?
And let's give repair to him. Identify item to you. So we have that also out of the way. Get some gold here.
Thanks.
Good. What's next? We have all the elemental skills in the training center.
Training?
You can learn arms master and bodybuilding. Or all characters, but that's a lot of gold right now that we don't need necessarily. This well doesn't heal anymore. We still got the MP well, I guess. And I think I give the horseshoes to you now. Set our priorities straight. Okay. Yeah, and then we heal a little bit here. And go into the cave, right? Because that is the only thing we can really visit since the dragon cave is sealed off. So nothing else we can really go. Or nowhere else. Let's see how we will fare against an army of spiders and stuff. I suppose there is an army of spiders, right? So let's go there. We know where the loot is, so
His Grace, Lord Markham, Duke of the Western Lowlands.
Red portion. Sally. Yeah, the beautiful shells. Okay. The longbow, okay, so it was in the treasure chest after all. And a tile, yeah. Okay. So get a lot of experience. Finish this, kept most of our bows, some good equipment here, and let's go. So each character has found something good. Conan has Duelist Blade of Acid, Jeff has his Devilbone Bow and the Royal Leather of Might, Harmony has the Regnan Tournament Shield, and here I guess, okay, poor girl Genovar would have loved the leather armor, but I want it on our thief, so there we go. Let's refresh this, grab the last corpses here. Refresh this, even though it lasts for days, and let's go into this cave. Let's see how many opponents will be in there this time. Temple of the Moon, here we go. You know the dungeon from my first playthrough.
This has all the makings for.
Let's see, I need more light here, it's pretty dark. They increase the darkness. What the heck, rogues? Okay, interesting. Maybe there are no spiders anymore here, that would be great. Fucking great. There was a chest for some nice loot and gold. Nice thing is now I can give everything to my thief. He is the identifier, the merchant, everything. First time I gave someone else the horseshoes but a mage, so at least in the beginning. She can solely focus on magic this time, I think. Besides maybe some alchemy. That's fine. Some gold here. There was nothing else really. Okay, so with our equipment I don't fear a few bets. They are way too easy. There is an army coming. Is these the spiders again? No, just more bats. Well, they are too easy. If they don't get near us, I think with all these pretty overpowered bows, there is no match here. There is a chest. Cutlass. Can't identify this yet. So we will identify this maybe later with our skill. For now, well, let's give it to our mage. Even though her armor class is kind of buffed already, the weakest armor class has actually Conan. So let's give this to our knight. Here's the buff's character, the most buff one. So it's fine. He hits the gym regularly. Though his bodybuilding skill is at zero right now. He should have even gained the haste buff. Oh, I see. No wizard's eye. First thing I will do is, I guess, fire and air expert again. Still no spiders in here, just bats. and ropes and thieves. Come on, die. You are running away. Our torchlight is offline again. There we go.
Sorry, can't help.
Just a crappy staff. Okay, then let's continue. Wow, even a master thief in here. Two of them.
Problem.
What the heck? Oh, that's scary. Kite, kite, kite. Got him. That was a strong opening for level 1.
Bring on a bigger challenge.
Okay, here comes the army of bats. At least no rats this time. So, thieves are in here to rob this place. Hold on. Come and get me. So, a few more enemies in the corners. There are a lot more enemies in the corners.
How do you like that?
Nice. Don't hit shit here. So, Spirit Expert, also pretty important. Found a shield. And another Master Thief. Well, you can stuck up there. Nice, okay. Got him. Then let's evade this trap again. Go in this direction. They think they can replace the monster, but not change the dungeons, so... There we go. The wealthy hat.
I'm not sure.
And a nice looking dagger.
No, I'm not sure.
And you need better identification.
Sure.
Wow, what the heck?
No, I'm not sure. It's me. No, I'm not sure.
Let's grab all of this for now.
No, I'm not sure.
Forget I need identification really badly.
It's me.
Wow. Master
it's
scroll.
Me.
And we found the knight statue already.
Forget
okay.
It.
So these quest items are also relocated. Interesting.
It's me.
I want to see the shields, I want to see this hammer, all the boots. You can wear them for now.
Sorry, can't help.
So we found the hat. And this dagger is probably stronger. Yeah, at least a little bit. Okay, some nice loot. Finally, the treasure chests are worth it. And the guard, well, they don't want to rob us. Our health hat anymore, so there we go. Okay. Still yellow lights. Antonio's Venezia tea, Venetian tea. What was that? I am not sure. Not sure at all what this did. Oh. Some evil swordsman in here.
It's just a small wound. I need healing.
Oh, oh, oh. Wow. They are buff. Got to be careful about this fire trap. Okay, got them. But now the other guard is also kind of evil. So the boss is in the other room again. Now that we have killed his friends, he wants revenge. Got all the spell scrolls, kind of. Some more bats. They won't matter. Just this cool looking staff. Or thief is already full. This time there is nothing else here. So we only have to go here for the head. Then I think we only need the loot. Yeah, we have a lot of spell scrolls. Torch, lightning, and awaken. We already know those, okay. Well, then I suppose we kill the last guard on the other side. Just for the experience. Three hit points. It should heal 7. Yeah, exactly. So the spell is not altered. Here we go, the end boss. Stop hitting my thief! What the heck, man? If you don't like thieves, you should have killed the raiders here. And that's that. Finish this dungeon pretty quickly. But it's okay, it's a beginner's dungeon, so I think you're supposed to go through this quickly. Now we only really need the loot, I guess. Yeah. I was thinking of that and just healed in the last second. Okay. Let's see. Master Sword, Expert Sword. Oh. Body Expert. I kind of want to get that right now. So maybe we train actually a few levels in here. Just so that I get it. It's closed anyways. Yeah, just body. Is there a back entrance to this? No, it's not. Just some kegs. Is there something in this building too? Makes me want to explore this. The Watchers. Scare rings of elemental magic and hit them in the land under the protection of a fierce guardian. Powerful indeed is the wizard who obtains these rings, okay. Yeah, okay. Let's go to the inn.
Come in.
What skills can we learn here? Perception and disarm trap. Well, let's take perception with us for now. Got this one too. Then I think we kind of... train for a day, but the store is closed, so never mind, I guess.
Come in, enjoy your stay.
Then we have to stay one day here in this godforsaken island.
Need a new weapon?
Let's see, I think we can sell this stuff. It's no way better than what we have on our dudes already. Warhammer, sure.
Bang.
The Warhammer is better than your normal hammer. Let's get this to the shop and sell all of this crap. Oh, I shouldn't have sold the helm. Probably find another one. Well, just a normal bronze shield. It looks cooler than it is. Kind of disappointing. Okay, and then we go to the magic shop, sell all of this other junk.
Can I help you with anything?
This looks a little bit more valuable, but yeah. I'll not sell the Master Scroll yet.
It's me.
Could be Town Portal.
I can't identify.
Why did we find a blaster weapon already? What is going on here? Don't really need recharge item, but I keep cure poison for now. Well then, let's turn the head in and buy us the loot, I guess.
Hello.
could also kill her, but that's no longer doable. It seems she has so many HP, so let's grab the loot.
His Grace, Lord Markham, Duke of the Western.
Okay, yeah, we found all six items, so here we go. Find it, and your ship. Good. Oh, and somehow we also finished this quest. Even without the dragon's cave. I guess we kill the dragon later. A scholar. A scholar is not bad.
Hi.
Unlimited identification and a 5% bonus on all experience gained. Yeah, you are hired. So with her in the party, we don't need identification anymore.
Forget it.
Pretty good.
Forget it.
Found a fly scroll. Well, can make use of that.
This is worthless.
So now we can identify everything. No more skill points needed for that. Pretty good. John, you are hired. Locksmith. I think this is the one we need to buff up the disarming a little bit, just to be safe. 6 points to disarm skill. Yep, you are hired too. So, if our NPC is gathered for now, I will exchange him later for someone that increases learning or what have you. There's another scholar.
How are you?
But she looks horrible. Let's not take her with us. Yeah, there we go. Let's leave to Harmondale, right? Finish this island. That was the first impression of the mod. Not bad.
Oh,
promotion to Water Magic Master, so this time you can get to Master pretty quickly. Retrieve the Watcher's Ring of Elemental Water and return it to me. The ring is guarded by a powerful sylph who lives on an island west of Sparward in the Bay of Athley. Okay. Well then, let's go.
Congratulations, my friends. Your new castle is located.
Yeah, this doesn't change. Here we go. Welcome to Harmondale, my new lords. As you can see, the streets are teeming with cheerful people. That's because the Erathian Festival of Five Moons has just begun. Enjoy the holiday. Okay. And the butler? So there are thieves in there now and ruffians. Okay. No more rats and stuff. Well, I want to explore this badly, but let's end the episode here and leave the fun for the next episode where we explore Harmondale. So yeah, so far this mod is interesting because it changes stuff and feels like a fresh game. It's nice, even though the mechanics are kind of the same. Why are we merchant expert already? Did I do something for this? I'm not sure how this works. But somehow everyone is a merchant expert now. Don't ask me what happened. But well, now everyone can at least sell all the stuff at the same price. Also fine by me. We have some skill points left. Just put the points into what I want to get to a higher level next. So since you can become Water Master now without going to Nyan, traveling will be a lot easier, so I think I will focus on water and air first. So I just put it to 2 so that we know, or that I can remember what I want to put up. And I guess for you right now, let's get you sword and yeah, just leave it at that. Okay, and that's it. See you back for the next episode. Have a great day, and bye-bye.